Okay. Hello, I'm Tim Drier, and what I'm going to attempt to show you today is one of my split goblets. And what I do is I take a piece of 3/16 inch thick borosilicate plate. I'm working with all borosilicate here. I'm using my rollers and my torch I mount on a slide, so my fire will be moving around, but I keep the glass fairly stationary. So I'm going to fire polish the edges of this plate glass, and I'm going to seal it inside the tube, heat it, blow it, and twist it, and then turn it into a cup. So I'm just going to go ahead and get started here. And like I said, this is just a piece of 3/16 inch borosilicate plate. That I'm just gonna warm up. And fire polish around the edges. So I'm just going to stick a handle on here. And that's the nice thing about borosilicate. It can take this kind of thermal shock, whereas if this was soft glass plate, you wouldn't be able to do that. So I'm warming this up quite rapidly. Now I'm just going to fire polish the edges because I sawed this so it would fit the inside of this piece of medium wall that I'm using. So like I said, I've cleaned the edges really good. Now I'm just fire polishing them. Because if I didn't do that, the inside edge would be all nasty looking where the seal connects to the inner tube. So now I'm just kind of pre-warming this piece of glass. Now I'm going to warm up my tube. Once I get this inside and tack it, that's when things start getting tricky. So I want to pre-warm this tube up good. And I have a stopper hooked to a blow hose, so when I close the end, then I'll be able to blow. So now I'm just going to heat and tack this piece of plate on the inside. And I want to keep it centered in the tube. So I want to make sure it's tacked good on both sides. Keep my heat on there. So now I'm going to walk the heat and seal that plate on both sides. So I'm walking my way down one side. Okay, now I can start walking down the other side. Because I'm trying to lay the outer tube down onto the plate. I just want to make sure it's stuck good. I'm going to heat the whole thing up and flow it in once I get it tacked really good. But I need to make sure it's stuck and there's not any air trapped in between. Now I need to close the end off without letting this end cool off. So I'm letting a lot of heat get into that heavy wall down there. And I come down here. And I want to keep things centered. So I'm going to pull things on center. There we go. So now I can pull my putty off. And now I can close this end off. Okay, so now I have the air trapped in there. It has nowhere to go. So now I can start to shape it by blowing. So this is about a 4.5 inch piece of plate that I just stuck in there. Now I need to attach a temporary handle. So I can hold the weight of it while I work on this end up here. So now I can really start to sink my heat into this piece of medium wall and that plate, because I want to let the heat sink in deep enough to get that plate soft so it moves when I blow as well. So I'm going to really let the heat sink into that. So then I come out of the flame, wait for it, you want to let it equalize, then start blowing and twisting. Because I want to try to keep it blowing out evenly and consistently. While I'm starting my twist. Come out of the flame. Wait for it. That looks pretty good. Now I can start working my way down, letting the heat sink into this second section. I'm not doing any blowing or twisting per se until I come out of the flame. So that's why I have my torch mounted this way, so I don't have to pick the whole thing off the rollers. So now I'm going to kind of taper this and stretch this end down. Pull my punty off. Because you want to pay close attention to where those transition corners are, that they don't stay sharp, or they'll crack. So now I'm going to thicken my punty back up. This is where I'll attach the foot. And now I can kind of even this out. By heating the whole thing up. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that shape. So now I'm going to do a fire cut on the top. So I'm going to heat a thinner section of glass, pull it and blow, and basically just tear it open. Thank you. set that aside. I'm going to try and square up this lip, which is going to be out of round because that's just the way the plate flows. But I'm going to try and clean it up as best I can. And there's a little extra glass on there, so I'm going to pick that off. So now I can just kind of square this lip up. I need to go a little bigger. So now I'm going to flame anneal this. Burn it off. Now I can make a foot. Warm this up. Get rid of all this on the bottom. Then I'm going to attach my punty on. and just blow up a little bubble. Making sure my punty line stays centered. Now I'll come back and do a fire cut, which again, just a thin fire, heating a thin band of glass, stretching, pulling, blowing till it tears open. While my fire's just skimming under the tube. And I heat just the lip. Bring it out, and I can see where it's tore. There's a little bit of extra glass. I want to get that off of there. Picking up the lip. So then I just flare it up. Keeping the heat on the farthest part of the lip that has to move the most. Tipping it up, tipping it back, till it's nice and flat. This kind of cool. In the meantime, I'm going to try and start warming this back up again. this in my holder. My roller's out of the way. Then I'm gonna thicken this, make this into the stem, put a big ball in there. This should be cool enough now to grab on the inside. Now we just put the two together. That's it. So now I'm just going to seal these two together. Then just do the final straightening of it. And if you come to Corning Studios, you can do this too. You can make one of these.
Awesome, Tim.
Yes. Okay, so what is it for, you ask? Well, I have one here, and suppose you like red and white wines, but you want them both at the same time and you don't want them to mix. So you take your white wine, and you pour it in half of it. Take your red wine and you pour it in the other side. Wait for it. And they never mix until you put them in your mouth.
Awesome.
See?
In this case, lemonade, right?
Right, in this case, lemonade. Sweet. Okay, so how much time do we have left? 22 minutes. All right, why don't I blow something else out of blue? But the Corning Studio, the Corning Museum, all of Corning Town, you can't get enough of this place. This is just a fascinating place. It always has been for me because glass has always been a big part of my life. And the environment that gets created in these studios is priceless. You can't put a price on it. It's the energy that's here is why I come here, to keep the energy flowing that you need to keep coming up with new ideas. And in combination with the museum and the studio, it's just the perfect setup. And I encourage everyone to come this way if you have not visited Corning. Okay, so I'm just gonna try and blow a little vase out of this blue tubing, which is just a 44 medium wall borosilicate. This is borosilicate blue, which is came out of China. It's actually a nice color. So we'll try and blow something out of this with the few minutes that I have left. I honestly didn't think it was gonna go that well, so I have a little extra time. So I'm just gonna close the end. I hooked on a fitting so that I can blow, and it keeps my swivel nice and straight. It helps with your bubble control. So I'm just gonna close the end. And like I said, keeping your glass stationary and moving your fire around is a kind of a different concept. A lot of people don't work this way. It's not better, it's just different. It gets different, you can achieve different results. So I'm just gonna close the end of this. And then punty up, add a handle to the bottom. So now I'm going to come back and neck this down just a little. by constricting this down just a little. And let it cool. Come out of the fire, let it equalize, and blow. Push up a shoulder. Then I'll just do a fire cut up here on the top. I'll just flare this up, and where there's that extra bit of glass, I just want to make sure I pick that off. Screw up the lip. Just flare it up. Burn this off. Set it aside. Take the same tube, make a foot. And again, it's just adding a punty, blowing a bubble, tearing it open, flaring it up. It's just the same process. So being that this is a small vase, I have to pay attention to how big my bubble is so I don't get too big. Probably big enough right there. Then again, I'm just heating a thin section, blowing it thin, blowing, pulling, twisting, and tearing it open. again, there's always going to be just the slightest bit of schmutz on the end. So you want to get that off of there, or it'll multiply as you flare the foot open. You just let gravity do the rest. It's just a question of letting it cool. Building up a little stem where I'm going to connect the two. Push up a little ball. It's just a question of warming it back up, fusing the two together. Thank you. That's how it's done. That's all I got. Thank you.